Hello friends, in this video I will talk about a problem which is from part C CSIR NET exam. So let us see the problem. So we need to find which of the following statements are true. So the first statement is ZX is a PID, which is principal ideal domain. The second option is ZXY, which is polynomial in two variables with coefficients from integers by the ideal generated by y plus 1 is UFD. And the third option is if R is a PID and P is a non-zero prime ideal, then this R by P has finitely many prime ideals. And the fourth option is if R is PID, then any subring containing unity, that is 1, is again a PID. So let us solve this problem. So the first option says that ZX is PID, but that cannot be possible because you have ideal generated by X and 2, where 2 is not the unit in Z. So the ideal generated by x comma 2, this is not principal ideal. This is not a principal ideal because it has two generators. So therefore the first option cannot be true. The ZX cannot be PID. Let us talk about the second option. So we need to find out the ZXY upon ideal generated by y plus 1 is UFD or not. That is unique factorization domain. So what is ZXY? ZXY upon the ideal generated by y plus 1. So what is this? So I will actually show that this is actually isomorphic to the polynomial ring ZX itself. So let us prove this, why this is true. So what we can do is we can define homomorphism from ZXY to ZX. So what is this? So there is a natural homomorphism, that is just we need to evaluate at the y variable. So what we do is map this polynomial with two variables p of x y to p of x comma minus 1. So this minus 1, so we are just evaluating this two variable polynomial at the minus 1, where y is equal to minus 1. So you can actually check that this is a homomorphism, and let us check why it is surjective. So this is important, that why it is surjective. So the surjectiveness is also easy. So if you take, so note that this p of x comma minus 1 is actually a one variable polynomial, right? So if you take, so take any p of x belongs to let us call it as Q of x. Q belongs to ZX, that is in the codomain. Then we need to find out the pre-mesh for this Q of x. So let me write it here. So if you take polynomial, so you define polynomial P of x y to be Q of x into minus y plus, okay, just q of x minus into minus y. So this is a polynomial with two variables. So note that this q of x is same, we have taken it here. So what is phi of p of x y? Phi of p of x y is same as q of x into, we need to evaluate at minus 1, right? Wherever there is a y, we need to put minus 1. So this is minus of minus 1 and this is 1. So The image of this p of xy is q of x. So recall this, we took q of x belongs to the z of xy, which was the domain, and we have found out the pre-image for this q of x. So that is same as q of x times minus y. In fact, we can take q of x itself by treating it as a polynomial with one variable inside the ring of polynomials in two variables. But that's okay, we just took the multiplication of q of x into minus y. So therefore we get that the phi is surjective homomorphism, right? Now here we can use the first isomorphism theorem. So we have the surjective homomorphism from zxy to zx. Now let us find out the kernel of this homomorphism. So what is the kernel? So the kernel of phi is same as all p of xy belongs to zxy such that p of x comma minus 1 is 0. Now you can actually see this z of xy, so this is again a polynomial with two variable, into y plus 1. So this polynomial belongs to the kernel of phi, right? Because if you put minus 1 here, you will get 0. So this is belongs to the kernel of phi. So, and conversely also we can prove that the any polynomial here in kernel phi is same as this. So the kernel phi is looks like zxy times y plus 1, right? But this is same as the ideal generated by y plus 1, right? So we got that the kernel of phi is ideal generated by y plus 1. So therefore, by first isomorphism theorem, what we get is the zxy by ideal generated by y plus 1 is actually isomorphic to zx. And we know that the zx is UFD. Zx is UFD. So that means this quotient ring is also UFD. So the second option is correct. Now let us check whether the third option is correct or not. So the third option was saying that if R is PID and P is any non-zero prime ideal, then the quotient R by P has finitely many prime ideals. So let me state a theorem here that I will prove it in my next video. So this is the third option. So this is actually the theorem. Let me state it. So every non-zero prime ideal in PID is maximal ideal, is maximal. So proof, actually I will the proof is in next video, and I will give this link in the description. So please visit this description. I will put link there. So this is always maximal. So using this theorem, what we get is, so if R is PID and P is a non-zero prime ideal, and by this theorem we know that any non-zero prime ideal of PID is maximal, so R by P has to be a field, right? So R by P is a field, which implies there is only two ideals, right? The ideals is a zero ideal and the whole ideal, the whole which is R. So there are, and the prime ideal is actually the only zero ideal. This was the only prime ideal. this was the only prime ideal in field. So that tells us that the third option is also correct. And the fourth option is, if R is PID, then any subring containing the unity 1 is again a PID. But this is actually not true. Let us see the counterexample for this. So the counterexample. So we can take the subring to be Zx. So in the first option itself, we seen that Zx is not PID. So you take this Zx is a subring of Q of X. Now Q is a field, and Q of X, then we know that the Q of X is always PID. But we already showed that Zx is not PID. This is not PID. So, and 1 is also belongs to this. So the unity also belongs to this. So we got the subring of Q of X. This Q of X is a PID, and we got the subring which contains unity, but it is not PID. So this tells us that the fourth option is not correct, and ultimately there are only two options which are correct, that is 2 and 3. So that's it for now. I hope you like this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like, share and subscribe if you find this useful, and also press that bell icon to get the all updates. Thank you.